This is Adam Vanelli of the Columbus River Dragons, your home for River Dragons hockey in Noonan, 99.
Hey, Mom and Dad, you want to teach your child biblical values that will last a lifetime? Why don't you check out the best-selling Adventure Bible? It's the number one Bible for kids, allowing them to take an exciting journey through each chapter with full-color illustrations, memory verses, hands-on activities, and more. The Adventure Bible is now available in four translations. It's the perfect Bible to encourage your children to stay in Scripture. Do you know at AdventureBible.com you'll find over 700 free games, activities, teaching resources, and more. Visit AdventureBible.com today.
Ready to earn some sweet Southern rewards? Check out the Southern Rewards Cashback account from Southern States Bank, where debit card transactions earn you cash back. With our Southern Rewards Cashback account, you can earn up to $30 a month. Sign up for your Southern Rewards Cashback account today. Terms and conditions apply. Visit your nearest branch or check us out online at southernstatesbank.net to learn more. Southern States Bank, your bank, your rewards. Equal housing lender, member FDIC, and MLS number 410611.
Wishbone Fried Chicken is back at a brand new location, 31 Jackson Street, Suite A here in Noonan. Same great taste, the best chicken around, fish dinners. Open Monday through Saturday, 10:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. It's Wishbone Fried Chicken, right next door to their former location, bringing you the best chicken around. So great. Wishbone Fried Chicken, 31 Jackson Street, Suite A, here in Noonan.
Hey there, folks. Looking for the top expert in Medicare, health insurance, and life insurance? Look no further than CP Financial. Meet Charmaine, your trusted agent. Charmaine works with multiple companies, ensuring you get the options tailored just for you. Why settle for less when you can have the best? 706-525-5931 and speak to Charmaine, CP Financial top local sales agent. Your peace of mind is just a call away.
Hey, this is Pastor Terrell Scott, and I come on Sunday at 11 a.m. and Tuesday at 11 a.m. bringing the Word of God to bring transformation, hope, and deliverance to your life. God loves you, cares about you, and wants to instruct and guide you in His Word. So I can tell you, Sunday at 11 a.m. and Tuesday at 11 a.m., tune in so your life can be radically changed forever, because God's love and care.
Welcome to the Hope, Healing, and Inspiration Radio Show here on 99.1 WQEE. I'm your host, Trish, the Mobile Chaplain.
And I am Railroad Muzik.
We have an amazing show lined up for you guys today. We have gospel group The Real Top Notch with artist E-Serve and Prayer P going to be in the building.
Prayer P late, y'all. What's up? E-Serve in the building. What's up? Real Top Notch. Sir Squad, what's happening, man? Thank y'all so much for having us. For real, for real.
Yeah, so welcome, E-Serve. So we're going to go right into the interview with you. Tell the listeners, who is E-Serve?
Yeah, I'm so happy to be here, first and foremost, man. I heard I have a great radio voice, so I'm really happy to be able to broadcast that talent. Most definitely. Hopefully something can come from this. But anyway, no, for real. So my name is E-Serve. Who is E-Serve? Good question. E-Serve, man, he's a father, right? He's a husband. He's a friend. He's a brother. He is, most importantly, man, he's a servant. You know what I'm saying? He's a servant of our Father Yahweh, God, as you may know him. And man, really, man, he's a man. When I say servant, I like to say I'm a servant leader as well too. I'm the leader of Surge Squad, which is what our ministry is called. If you follow us on Surge Squad, when you do follow us, you'll see a lot of different artists. We've been labeled as the Wu-Tang Clan of Christian hip hop, because it's a lot of us. It's like six of us. I think Wu-Tang had more, today representing is a real top notch here out of Serve Squad, E-Serve, and Prayer P again, who's late. He'll be here when he be here, though. He's usually not late. Let me say it like that. We're very, very punctual people, man. As a matter of fact, I was here 30 minutes. I was here before you. I was here 30 minutes early. I was down, yeah. So I'm always on time for stuff. But thank you so much for having us.
Oh, glad to have you. So E-Serve, tell me, how do you feel about the label Christian rap, as the world the label Christian rap?
Yeah, man. I thought about this. I saw the question. Shout out to Ron Moore for the dope question, first and foremost. Railroad Muzik. And to be honest with you, when I thought about it, I was like, I don't feel no type of way. That was my honest answer. I'm going to be real with you. The world has to, there's a label for everything, right? When I thought about it, I was like, man, you know, gangster Muzik, when people started talking about gangster stuff on tracks, they started calling it gangster rap. You know what I mean? You know, you got trap rap, you got trap Muzik, you got all different type of stuff. Man, when you call it Christian rap, you know, off top, they're going to identify Christianity as a religion, right? So when I look at it, man, when people call it that, I'm fine with that because I'm looking to provoke a conversation with whoever's listening anyway, right? So when they say Christian rap, I look at it as an opportunity to provide, look, man, this is really a relationship, you know what I'm saying? This is really a relationship over religion. But if that's the name you want to throw on it, I'm cool with that. You know what I mean? I've heard Christian rap. I've heard gospel rap, right? You know what I mean? I've heard Christian trap. I've heard all of that, man. I've heard that, man. The world has to put a label on something to identify, you know, what we're talking about. Like I said, at the end of the day, man, you know, call it whatever you want to call it. Christ is the center of it. You know what I mean? And let's have a talk about that. You know what I mean? So, man, like I said, I went back and forth with that question in my head. I'm like, God, what should I say? He's like, say what you feel. You know what I mean? It doesn't bother me at all, but I know it bothers the world because at the end of the day, man, Christ Jesus, like Jesus Christ, is the most conflicting name in the world. You know what I'm saying? It's the name that shakes people to their core, right? You know what I mean? And I think about it, man, it's mocked. You know what I mean? It's going to be mocked. You know, you throw Christian rap on anything, you throw Christian on Christian rap is going to be mocked. Why? Because Christ is mocked. You know what I mean? Right. You know what I mean? So, and you got to be prepared for that. You know, we defend the faith and Christian hip hop just like you would defend it at a Christian church or a Christian organization, Christian this. It doesn't matter. You know what I mean? At the end of the day, bro, I look at it as like, look, bro, I'm communicating the truth on tracks to you. Call it what you want to call it. It is what it is.
It's what it is.
I came up with that question was I was watching. I know you heard of Pastor Geno Jennings.
Who did he say? I couldn't remember.
Geno Jennings.
Geno Jennings. I've heard of him. Yeah.
Shout out to Geno Jennings. I watch him. You know, I listen to a lot of his work, and I don't have really anything bad to say about him. But I saw what he had said about Christian rap, that there's no place for it because it's too worldly. And the reason I had an issue with that statement is because it's the gospel. You know what I'm saying? We're spitting the gospel. Just because it's in a rap form doesn't change that it's the gospel. You know what I'm saying? So it kind of struck me a little bit when I heard him say that it doesn't have a place. That's like saying, you know, a preacher is a speaker.
Right.
There are speakers of the world, then there are speakers of the gospel, which is a preacher or evangelist. So you're telling me there shouldn't be any preachers or evangelists because they're evangelists in the world. So that was my question. But, you know, we speak the gospel. And you can call it, like you said, Christian rap or whatever you want to call it. But we're speaking the word.
Yeah, man. So I hear that so much, man. I think even it's looked at as a negative light. My thing is this, man. God will meet you wherever you are. You know what I mean? Period. You know what
Amen.
I'm saying?
Amen.
And as the time changes, you know what I'm saying? You know, God doesn't change, but his methods may change, right? According to, to the generation. You know what I mean? You know, man, I've seen the gospel preached in places where you wouldn't even think it would be preached. You know what I'm saying? You know, where it's needed, right? You know, like I hear what they're saying, but they don't even know. Like, bro, I've been in places, bro. I've been in I've been in clubs, you know what I mean? And God has used me with my message to go into clubs, you know what I'm saying? And infiltrate, you know what I mean? Satan's dominion, right? To bring the gospel, you know what I mean? But at the end of the day, bro, you know, that's the work. Look, man, the thing is that it's a gift. Call it what you want to call it, right? Say it's worldly, but it is a gift from Yahweh, right? It is a gift that he has given us, man, to reach people, right? And the word of God says, look, bro, your gift is going to make room for you. You know what I mean? What I'm coming to the conclusion is like, okay, when you get that room, what do you do with that room, right? well, you decrease in that moment and you glorify him. So I get what he's saying, that, oh, it looks worldly, because I'm going to be honest with you, man. I have heard some Christian hip hop, some Christian rap, you know what I mean, that sounded a bit worldly, where it seems like the culture is more so influencing the music versus the music influencing the culture. And I think they do that because they feel like, you know, they have to, you know, sneak in a certain way. Man, at the end of the day, Christ said, look, man, if I be lifted up, I'm going to draw a man unto me. Amen. You know what I'm saying?
Amen. That's the word.
that's the word, bro. That's the truth. You know what I mean? So I'm really, man, I love your response. And, I, you know, shout out to Gino Jennings, man. You know, powerful, powerful man of God. You know what I mean, I get where he's coming from. But I'm here to tell you, but look, bro, Christian hip hop is not going anywhere. It's not. It's not, man, period.
Okay, so do you feel like your music is a representation of the gospel as the gospel is written, or do you like write from everyday life experiences? Because I'm going to give you an example of, because, you know, I'm an artist too, so when I write, it's coming from God. I really don't write from everyday experiences, but I know gospel artists who do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's just how we get our different inspirations. How do you get your inspiration?
Man, great, great question. So I'm with you on there, man. I believe, bro, the message starts in the Word of God, period. You know what I mean? You know, I draw my inspiration from the Word of God, but I also tie in my life experiences as well, too, right? And what I mean by that is, like, you know, through my life experiences, I've encountered the Word of God. You know what I'm saying? I've encountered God through that. So I think you need to draw inspiration from both. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Period. Because at the end of the day, people want to be related to as well, right? Bro, people are looking for the real. I'm talking about, man, the time that we live in now, bro, you got to be real. People want to know that you've been through something, you know what I'm saying? And they want to know how you overcame as well, right? So with me, bro, I'm very open about what I've struggled with, you know what I mean? I have no problem doing that because, number one, you know, his grace is sufficient and his power is made perfect in all of my weaknesses, you know what I mean? But I have no problem addressing my weaknesses, which are the life experiences, you know what I mean, that I draw inspiration to, man. And in that right there, man, people can have an encounter with God alone. But because from there, I'm letting them know, like, look, bro, this is how I got through this. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I struggle with pornography. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I struggle with all different type of things. Yeah, I struggle with drugs. All right. But, you know, this is how I overcame. This is what I found in the Word of God. You know what I mean? To help me, you know what I mean? To draw strength from Christ, you know, in those manners. And here's the word that he gave me to give me strength to move forward. It's not just overcoming, but to move forward in him as well, too, man. Mm-hmm. So you need both, right? At the end of the day, bro, also to me, you have to know how to read situations, you know what I mean? Because,
yeah,
bro, off top, you know, people are just, you know, may not respond, you know what I'm saying, to the Word of God right up front, you know what I mean? If I come in, I'm like, oh, man, God said love your neighbor as yourself, but this name, like, well, bro, I get that, but that ain't really speaking to me, you know what I'm saying? You know,
right.
you, man, he who winneth souls is wise, yes. You know what I'm saying? So, bro, just having a conversation, man, with where they are, you know what I mean, relating right there opens up the door, man, for the Holy Spirit to move, and I mean, for them to have an encounter with God, right? So, you got to have wisdom, man. You come in here Bible thumping off top, bro, you may lose them. I'm going to be honest with you. You may lose them.
Right.
You know, I tell people all the time, you got to know your audience. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. absolutely. Pray a peacock with me.
Okay, well, we're going to go to commercial break, and we'll be right back with the real top-notch E-Serve and Prayer P. We're going to listen to one of their songs, and they're going to tell you whether you can see them on May 17th.
Yeah, the 47th spot, man. If you're in Columbus, I got, hey, look, you don't want to miss that. Pull up, man. That's going to be an experience right there, for real.
All right, we'll be right back after these messages.
Looking for the right bank to be your partner? Experience the difference at Southern States Bank. At Southern States Bank, we're not just your bankers, we're your partners. Our team is deeply rooted in the community, and we take pride in providing personalized service. Come to Southern States Bank, where great service comes naturally. Visit us today or check us out at southernstatesbank.net. Southern States Bank, your community, your bank. Equal housing lender, member FDIC, NMLS number 410611.
In the market for either buying or selling your home, City First Mortgage Service, LLC, is the first place for all your needs. Branch manager John P. Lewis and his staff can serve you with a smile and professional courtesy. Serving Georgia, Alabama, Florida, 770-598-0860. John P. Lewis, City First Mortgage Service, LLC. We place you first.
Hey, this is Pastor Terrell Scott, and I come on Sunday at 11 a.m. and Tuesday at 11 a.m. bringing the Word of God to bring transformation, hope, and deliverance to your life. God loves you, cares about you, and wants to instruct and guide you in His Word. So I can tell you, Sunday at 11 a.m. and Tuesday at 11 a.m., tune in so your life can be radically changed forever because God's love and care.
I am Apostle Deborah Harris, Pastor Apostle of Kingdom Connected Ministries International at 121 Hillwood Circle, Noonan, Georgia. Presenting Connecting the Kingdom. Connecting kingdom citizens, kingdom businesses, and advancing the kingdom of God in this hour. Join us each Tuesday at 10 o'clock a.m. with guests who are sharing their faith, business, and ministry.
Welcome back to the Hope, Healing, and Inspiration Radio Show here on 99.1 WQEE. I'm your host, Trish, the Mobile Chaplain.
And I'm Railroad Music.
We have the real top notch in the building. We have E-Serve and Prayer P on the mic.
Prayer P finally made it, y'all.
Yeah, I'm finally here, y'all. Finally here.
And what we're going to do right now, they have a song they want to release to the listeners today. So, y'all, tell us about the song.
All right, this song is called See What I See. All right. Now, this is pretty common right now in the industry. We know the industry's wild right now. The industry's getting real demonic. It's going in another direction. I don't have to tell y'all. Y'all can see it with your own eyes. So basically, this song is basically talking about that, the direction that this industry is going, how it's not of God. You know what I'm saying? We got to stop being worldly. We got to open our eyes, see what's really going on out here. And, you know, we got to adjust and get in that word. And we got to teach our young folks the right way and stop letting the industry teach our kids. You know what I'm saying? See what I see. Top notch.
Let's go.
For the glitter and gold, we'll find some man if you give him the soul. But you've been on me, I've been in before. Devil, he know that I'm doing the smoke. We the commission, let's get it and go. We stay on the mission to give it a go. I dust off my feet when I walk out my streets. You gotta believe it to see what I see. Started there for the glitter and gold. We'll find some man if you give him the soul. But you've been on me, I've been in before. Devil, he know that I'm doing the smoke. We the commission, let's get it and go. We stay on the mission to give it a go. I dust off my feet when I walk out my streets. You gotta believe it to see what I see.
You ain't selling no dope, you just selling your soul. I see all the symbols, I see all the codes, I see all the wickedness all in your clothes, I see all the rituals all in your shows. I see what you're doing, you casting a spell, you thinking it's heaven,
it's actually hell.
Your whole society taking the L, the industry where the demons are dwell, but not just the music, the actors, the news, the ball players, and the politics, and the activists. Yes, they corrupt, they'll do whatever when the checks are cut. Just cut the cameras, you can see that they mad, they really need help and it really is sad. They hate what they did, the ultimate sin, the only way out, you gotta repent.
I started different, the glitter and gold. Some man if he give up the soul. But you been on me, I've been in before. Devil, he know that I'm doing the smoke. We the commission, let's get it and go. We stay on the mission to give it a go. I dust off my feet when I walk out my streets. You gotta believe it to see what I see. I thought it different the glitter and gold. We'll find some man if he give up the soul. But you been on me, I've been in before. Devil, he know that I'm doing the smoke. We the commission, let's let's get it and go. We stay on the mission to give it to go. I dress up my feet when I walk up the streets. You gotta believe it to see what I see. Any, mini, money, mo, pick a soul. You ain't really in control, but you know. Said that you love it, you really your puppet. You might not discuss it, put on for the public. You really the ops, you not really hot. You snitching your partner and calling the cops. You really put on, you might be a clone. You sip on that lean and you get in the zone. To rap about something you not really about. And they put it out to build up the clout. You pick up a charge, they put you in jail. You open your mouth, cause you finna tell. Snitch. We know you well, yeah, we know your name. You not from the set, you not in the game. You really a lame who fell into fame. Sold out for the deal, and that's when you change. I saw the deal for the glitter and gold. We'll find some man if you give up the soul. What you been on, man, I've been in before. Devil, he know that I've been with the smoke. We the commission, let's get it and go. We stay on the mission to give it and go. I dust up my feet when I walk out my streets. You gotta believe it to see what I see.
Run it back.
I saw it. Deal for the glitter and gold. We'll find some man if he give up the soul. What you been on, man, I've been in the fence. Devil, he know that I've been with the smoke. We the commission, let's get it and go. We stay on the mission to give it and go. I just got my feet when I walk up the streets. You gotta believe it to see what I see.
Okay, welcome back to the Hope, Healing, and Inspiration Show. I'm your host, Trish the Mobile Chaplain.
I am Railroad Music.
And what you just heard was the real top notch. Tell us what it was.
See what I see.
See what I see.
Yeah. Man, that thing's so hard, bro. Yeah. Woo.
Appreciate it.
Yes, sir. Yeah, thank you. Appreciate that.
That was a hard song. And again, you can catch them at the 47th spot next Friday, May 17th in Columbus, Georgia.
Oh, yeah. It's going down. It's going down in a major way.
Yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So, what was the driving force? What made you guys get into Christian rap music?
Well, I say what drove us to get into Christian rap. Well, you know, he got into Christian rap before I did, long before I did, and he stayed, you know, praying for me, hoping I got in Christian rap. But I'll say what drove us to do Christian rap was basically the word of God. You know what I'm saying? As Christians, you know, after you turn your life over to Jesus Christ, it is now your duty. It is our duty to go out here and spread the gospel, and as well as you know, get some more souls for the kingdom of heaven. Amen. All right. So and everybody has their own talents. Everybody has their own gifts. And God told us we're supposed to use these gifts to help minister to people and help bring people closer to God. So we're artists, so our ministry is music. So, you know, this is what it is, you know what I'm saying? So we give your life to Christ. It's all about how you're going to use those talents that God gave you to get that out to the people. And music is just our outlet.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Encourage the listeners, somebody who may be listening based off something you may have went through or you may have went through that made you give your life to Christ. Encourage somebody.
You
want to
go first, guys?
Let's see. You go ahead.
You went in? All right. So look, this is where I always start off. I start with relating. Brother, sister, whomever, I get it. Like, I get it. I get the struggles. I've been depressed. I've wrestled with depression, mm-hmm. right? I've wrestled with identity. You know what I'm saying? Man, I've wrestled with 1 foot in the world, 1 foot in the church, as they say, as the old schoolers say. You know what I mean? Here's the truth as well too. I used to be scared of God more than I loved God. You know what I mean? And I'm talking about, man. Here's the thing, man. When you really come into the truth on who Christ is, you know what I mean? Look, man, it is liberating. You know what I mean? Like, and I'm not saying that. Look, bro, all of your problems, all your situations, I don't want you to look at it like God is like, oh, man, he's going to fix everything that I'm going through, every problem, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. No, but what he can do, man, is use those problems to reveal himself to you, you know what I mean? Right. And show you his presence and show you his glory, show you how awesome it is, you know what I mean? Man, if you're feeling something in your heart, if you're feeling something tugging in your heart, like, look, bro, something's different. So I feel like I need to go another direction with my life. Don't ignore it. The Bible says that Jesus says, look, man, behold, I stand at the door and knock. You know what I mean? If any man will open up, yeah, I'll come in and I'll sup with them. I'll make my home within them. Man, look, respond, because, man, the days are short. You know what I mean? We have no hope outside of Christ. I'm say that again, bro. Like, look, bro, we have no hope outside of Christ. I don't care how much money you make. I don't care what your status is. I don't care what you're driving in, what kind of home you have. I don't care. There is no hope outside of Christ, man. There you go.
Exactly. So what we have to do is I challenge everyone listening. You have to set aside some time for God. You have to make time for God. All right. You have to make some commitments to God. Okay. You're gonna have to change the way you live. You know what I'm saying? Change the way you think. And that's just how it is. If you want to get some change, then you're going to have to do something different. And if you want to do something different, if you're going to try to be like somebody, then you need to be like Christ.
Like Christ.
You know what I'm saying? Don't be like these celebrities. Don't be like your best friends. No, because everybody's flawed. You know what I'm saying? Only person that is free of sin and all of that is Jesus. You know what I'm saying? You got to follow in his footsteps and be more Christ-like and make some time for Jesus. You got to set aside some time to pray. Set aside some time to read your Bible. Set aside some time to try to minister to somebody, to try to help somebody. Serve God as well as serving others. Don't forget to serve others, you know, because a lot of people forget serving others. Oh, I don't know him. I don't know. You got to know him.
You can't serve God without, man, without serving others, bro. You
got to do both. That's just what it is.
You can't, bro. It is what it is.
The real top notch.
Okay. Yeah, the real top notch in the building. We got Easter Prayer P. Mm-hmm. Okay, tell the listeners how they can follow you and your music.
Okay, you can hit us up on Instagram. What is it? The Real Top Notch 1?
Yeah, The Real Top Notch 1. The number 1.
The number 1.
Right. You can find us on all music platforms. The Real Top Notch. The album we just released is called Me and My Dog.
Yeah.
Just an EP, giving them a taste of what's to come. As a matter of fact, shout out to the Father, man. The album is sitting about 75,000 plus streams.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
So I keep getting great testimonies, man. About people that's inspired, they've listened to it, man. It's awesome, man. God is doing a great thing within our ministry. Also, Serve Squad. Follow Serve Squad. That is SURV Squad. Again, we spell serve a cool way. SURV. All right. Look up Serve Squad. Shout out to the squad. Baker the Legend, J1, yeah. Anna Serve, John Henry. Yeah, follow them. And anything else? Oh, Serve Apparel.
Serve Apparel. Go check out the merch. You know, we got Serve Apparel. That's SURVAPPAREL .com. Serve Apparel. We got stuff for kids. We got stuff for everybody. We got winter stuff as well as summer stuff. All right?
All right, Railroad. Any last minute inspiration?
Railroad. Of course. First of all, I want to say thank you to Real Top Notch and Serve Squad. You know, appreciate y'all coming. Y'all guys are doing some great work, man. Y'all got some good music. And as people can see that we're not only just artists, that we actually minister the word as well. We don't just go out there and rap, speak as well. So y'all follow these guys, man. They're a great inspiration. And it ties into the word this morning, too. So I'm coming out of Psalms 145:17. It says, "The Lord is righteous in all his ways, mm-hmm. and holy in all his works." You know, and the morning inspiration behind that is we regularly praise God for his righteousness, and we thank him for his faithfulness. Mm-hmm. But today, let's meditate on what those words really mean and how beautifully they go together. Because Yahweh is righteous. He is pure and good in all his ways. Not some of his ways, all his ways.
All his ways.
Never act on with evil intent, because evil is contrary to his nature. Mm. And because he is faithful, his goodness never fails. He never forgets us or misses our opportunity to show us his love. That's inspiration for this morning. And y'all, let's meditate on that word this morning.
All right.
Amen, bro. Amen.
Amen. Well, we thank the Real Top Notch E-Serve and Prayer P for coming on the show today.
Again,
tell the people where they can see y'all May 17th.
Oh, man, the 47th spot. Come on, man. Shout out Bishop Adam and the whole crew,
come
man.
Man,
Railroad Music. Trish, the mobile chaplain, man. It's going to be a movie, man. Y'all pull up.
It's going to be nice.
Man, look. Just pull up. I ain't got nothing to say. Just pull up. That's it.
Hey, we're trying to get some people saved.
Columbus, Georgia. Come on. Let's go.
Let's go.
All right. This has been our show today. I am Trish the Mobile Chaplain. Everybody have a blessed week. We'll see you next Friday at 11:30 here on the Hope, Healing, and Inspiration Radio Show. Everybody be blessed.